Assalamu alaikum students. I hope you people are all fine. In the last lecture, we discussed about the techniques which are implemented at the level of pre-writing. Before actually writing, we have to indulge at the level of pre-writing, and there are few techniques. If we follow those techniques, we can improve our writing, and our writing can be more persuasive and more applicable. So after following or indulging on in all those techniques and activities, then we will move towards particularly and practically to writing. So at the level of writing, there are few steps and phases which should be followed. Those steps will be shared with you people today, and you should keep all these steps in mind whenever you are writing something, either that is academic writing or that is fictional writing or creative writing. If you'll keep these steps in your mind, your writing will be automatically more better. So the first step is identify your purpose. You people can see it on page number 72 on the book which has been recommended to you. So the first step is identify your purpose. So if we'll identify our purpose, for what purpose we are writing that text, and what is the use of that text. So if we'll keep this in mind, our writing will be better. Either we are writing for the purpose of criticism, our style and our writing will be different. Either we are writing for the purpose of conveying some information, either we are writing to pursue something. So first of all, we have to identify the purpose of our writing. Either we are just writing to convey our knowledge to other, or we are writing that for passing the examination, whatever our purpose is. If we'll keep our purpose in mind, in the same way you people can see that if the question is of 10 marks, so we'll have the purpose to cover the material, to convey the material equal to 10 marks. So if the question is of 5 marks, or there are two questions, one question is of 5 marks, another question is of 10 marks, so we'll know our purpose and the knowledge we are trying to convey and the material which we'll provide to the examiner, that will be according to our purpose. I hope you people have understood now the aspect of purpose. What will be the purpose of our writing? Our writing will be according to that purpose. Next thing is analyze the audience or identify the audience. To whom we are writing that text? Either that person is educated or not, either that person can read, whether that person is highly qualified or not, our vocabulary, our structure, our syntax, our style should be according to the level of reader. If we'll not keep in mind the reader while writing, so it will not be applicable. Reader may not understand the text, or if the reader is highly qualified, he would consider your writing very ordinary. So you should keep in mind the audience to whom you are writing, and then you will write according to the level which will determine the education, which will determine the qualification, rank, all those aspects. So if you keep in mind while writing, your writing will be much more applicable. Next element is choose your idea. What are you trying to write? Na? If we just talk about the essay, on what topic you are going to write that essay? So when you will have an idea, you will automatically indulge into the level of pre-writing. You will brainstorm, you will try to gather the ideas, then you will link all those ideas with the help of mind mapping, and then you will organize those ideas and materials with the help of outlining the whole text. So all these steps are very applicable, and we should keep in mind while writing. The next fourth element is collect your data. Whatever the topic you are trying to write, you have to collect data. Suppose you are trying to write a book on the history of Pakistan, so you will have to consult the other writers. You will have to collect the data that will help you to write since 1947 to 2020. So You, whenever we write something, we have to collect data, we have to collect arguments, we have to collect material which will help us to write, which will make our writing better than others. And the next fifth element is organize, which means what to write first and what to write at the second or later phases. So it all these elements should be followed while writing, which will help us to make our writing better. Next is the element of chronology. Chronology means to write something. Now we are talking about different kinds, different structures in which we can order, with which we can structure our writing. First among all those is chronological order. Chronology means to order the writing, to order the events according to time. Whenever some incident happened, we'll just prioritize, we'll just order it according to the time when it occurred or happened. If we just talk about my educational career, so I'll say that I did my matriculation in 2008, then I did my intermediate in 10, then I did my graduation in 13, then I did my master's in 15. So that is chronological order. If we just try to write about Pakistan, so we'll say that Pakistan got its independence in 1947. First constitution was given in 1956. Seventh constitution was given in 1962. Third constitution was given in 1973. If we talk about wars, first war held in 1948. Second war held in 1965. Third war held in 1971. And fourth war held in 1998 or 1999, that Kargil war. So it means that is called as chronological order. We can order events according to chronology of happening the events. Second one is from specific to general. It is also known as inductive. If we just say that by mentioning any particular vegetable, we'll just keep on moving at the level of vegetable and then at the level of plants and then at the level of trees and all those herbs. So it will be from moving specific to general. The other one is from moving general to specific, which means we'll move from broad to narrow, which means first we'll just mention animals. Then we'll mention those animals which can be eaten in Muslims and which are considered haram in Muslims. Then we'll refer to mammals and other category of animals. Then we'll refer those who just prey on others. Then we'll refer who are herbivores and who are carnivores and who are omnivores. So then we'll particularly move towards lion. So that is from general to specific. We can use any of this structure according to our purpose, according to our need. And next one is comparison and contrast. Compare means to try and find the similarities between two things. We can say that blue and blue. What is the similarity between two things? So the other one is contrast. In contrast, we try and find out the differences between two things. So you people might have understood that when we will just try to write the comparison, so we'll keep on mentioning the similarities between two things and we'll continue our writing. And if we'll just follow the element or structure of contrast, we'll keep on mentioning the differences between two structures. And the next element is problem solution pattern. If you are writing according to or purpose of problem solution, first you will put in the problem and then you will suggest the solution. This kind of structure, this kind of writing is usually followed in research aspects. When we have any kind of problem, any kind of issue, any kind of ambiguity in our research purpose, so we'll mention, we'll refer those problems, and then by conducting research, by consulting the review, by consulting the authorities, or by conducting any kind of experiment, we'll try and provide the solution to that problem. So that is the other structure which can be followed, which can be implemented in the writing. And next one is cause and effect. This is also used in research, where first we refer to cause, first we mention the cause, and then we refer, or then we move to the effect of that cause. In the same way as we can say that if you will work hard, that is the cause, you may gain better marks in the examination. That is the effect of that cause. We can proceed our writing in this way by mentioning the cause and effect of the writing. You people can consult the book from page number 72, 3 and 4, and you will be able to learn or read all these materials there. If you will have any kind of issue, do let me know and try and understand and grab all these aspects which we discussed at the level of pre-writing and at the level of writing. We should also, there is a phase which is not mentioned here, that is post-writing. After writing all that material, we should consult. Usually, while writing the paper, we consult spelling, grammar, but we should also consult the structure. If we are writing in software such as Microsoft Word or PowerPoint or anything else, we may shift one sentence or one paragraph from last to middle or middle to end. That is the order of hierarchy. That is the order of cohesion and coherence, which we discussed at the level of reading, that what, how things are related, how things are organized and structured. So we should also keep in mind the element of past, right, post writing. Got that? So I hope you people have understood. As in the next lecture, we'll move towards the structure of paragraph writing. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.